Mr. Powell, I'd like to introduce you to Frederick Douglass.
Your first autobiography was remarkable. I haven't had a chance to crack the second, but I'm sure we're not disappointed.
I hear you've just returned from abroad.
England.
I spent some time in the Kensington area. It's not my place of birth, but I was reborn there. To be treated not as colored, but as a man.
One hopes we can achieve such here in America.
Tonight will certainly help us get closer to that goal. We have exceeded our largest intake by a country mile.
Well, if it's one thing I've learned from your print, it's that the success of the abolitionist movement hinges on Northern public support. And from you, sir, nothing inspires said support more than the heroism of the runaway.
I do have my concerns that we're often too public when we speak of our secret network.
There is a balance that needs to be found, but tales of successful flight can inspire those yet in bondage to action.
While also cutting off their routes to freedom. It's why I kept the exact details of my own escape out of my book. We cannot overexpose it.
Says the most photographed man in the world.
Touche. But image is important. A single photo can do more to alter the perception of the race than any vile words shouted in hatred. Men like you need to be seen and heard as much as possible.
Our talking is great, but I'm one for action. Revolution, like that cracker from Kansas, John Brown.
There's some distance between us and Mr. Brown's methods.
But we do all agree that war is inevitable. The world is getting hotter. I think that means that emancipation is on the horizon.
I spent years out in the field looking at the horizon. Here's the thing about it. You can't ever quite get to it, can you?
We need to put him in a room with Harriet.
Did I tell you I finally convinced her to speak?
Oh. Earth might stop turning.
Just secure the location.
How do we think she's gonna do?
I don't want that woman to fail at anything.